Hi, welcome to our smart board. In the example I'm going to discuss with you, we will look at the flow of a thin layer of water across a vertical wall. So here's my sketch. This is the wall, and this with this wavy interface, I denote the interface of the water. Liquid is coming down. And I will use a coordinate system with x in the horizontal direction from 0 to delta, the thickness of the layer, and y denoting the vertical direction. As we deal with water, we have a Newtonian liquid. Moreover, I'll consider a steady state and a laminar flow. So at rather small Reynolds numbers, which I won't specify. And the questions to be answered are, one, what is the velocity of the water as function of position? Two, what is the flow rate of water per unit of length as the thickness of the layer, and the depth, I mean, doesn't play a role in this problem. All right, let's see how we analyze these. First, we need to realize that steady state and laminar means that we can use sum of forces is zero. So rather than a momentum balance, I'll calculate a force balance. And I also realize that the flow and all forces that are relevant will be in the y direction. Thus, I need a control volume that captures that. Here's my control volume. Gravity is pulling down, and at the sides there may be a shear trying to move it up or down. I don't know the sign yet. Since this is a very tall plate, high and deep, pressure effects can be ignored. The pressure is the same everywhere. Moreover, it's open to the atmosphere, so the pressure must be equal everywhere. Hence, I don't need to take into consideration pressures working on this control volume. The control volume goes from x to x plus dx and y plus dy. And I see from my sketch that I need three forces that balance each other. Okay, I'm going to write down which they are. On the left side, there is on the area wdy, which is this face, so perpendicular to the drawing, w being the length scale in that direction, on that area of the control volume, there is a shear stress x sub y at position x. It's the left part. On the other side, there is on the same magnitude of area, a shear stress, but that carries a minus sign because of the definition of layer with small coordinate on larger coordinate in the shear stress. And this larger coordinate sitting on the outside, carrying a minus sign because of action is minus reaction when you want the force on our contour volume. And then obviously I shouldn't forget the driving force for this entire motion, which is gravity, which acts on the entire volume. Okay, and this needs to be equated to zero. Now, first of all, w is a dummy variable that can be scratched out. I can scratch out dy as well. It's everywhere present also. Then I can bring these two to the other side. So tau xy at x plus dx minus tau xy at x, and I divide that by the dx that's sitting here, giving me the derivative. So it's the derivative of x with respect to x of tau xy equals then what remains of gravity, minus rho g. All right, this equation is relatively easy to solve. Tau xy, the shear stress profile as a function of x, equals minus rho g x plus some integration constant c1. To find the integration constant, I need a boundary condition. Luckily, I have one. I know that at the interface with the air, the frictional force from the air is very, very small, meaning that I can equate it to zero. Air hardly has any density. It has a low viscosity, so it's very mobile. And whatever motion there is here, the air will be dragged so that there's no relative velocity. It cannot really drag it back. So this is a very good approximation. But it translates that the liquid must obey there that the shear stress at the interface is zero. All right, let's move this a little bit. If that is the case, that is zero at delta, then I can quickly see that C1 is fixed and that the shear stress is given in the entire layer by rho g delta minus x. Or if I make a quick drawing, as a function of x, this is the shear stress. Which makes sense, because every layer close to the wall will try and hold back the other layers and have exert an upward force as the velocity close to the wall is low because of the presence of the wall, and the velocity here away from the wall will be highest downward. Okay, if I have that, now I can equate, and we'll do that in yellow, I can equate the velocity, since this is via Newton's law for Newtonian liquids, minus mu times the derivative of the y component of the velocity, and that equals this rho g times delta minus x. Also, this one can be easily solved. Divide minus mu to the other side and integrate, and you get v sub y, let me shift it a little bit, it's somewhat easier to write, equals minus rho g over mu, and then integrating this one is delta x minus x squared over 2 plus a second integration constant. For that I need a boundary condition. I know the boundary condition. At the wall there's the stick condition, Vy is 0, thus this C2 is 0. And my solution is this part. Once I have that, I can try and find the flow rate per unit area, or per unit length actually, which is the integral of Vy over the thickness of the layer. I divided the W away, that's the prime. But let me first draw this one, so that we have that also in the picture. The velocity is negative, downward, and it's half a parabola. Okay, I need to equate now the integral to find the flow rate per unit depth of the plate. That is, I ignore the minus because this is an absolute value. This, oh, it's rho g over mu, integral of delta x minus x squared over 2 dx, and this integral equals delta x squared over 2 minus another third, so that makes a sixth x to the third between boundaries 0 and delta. At 0 there's nothing, at delta it's delta cubed, a half minus 1/6 is a third delta cubed, so this integral becomes, for the flow rate, rho g over 3u times delta 3 cubed, and you got your answer here. All right, let's flip up the entire analysis. Can I do that in a 50%? No, slightly too small.
That's better.
Here you see the entire analysis. Read this back for yourself and try and understand the bigger picture, which steps are taken and why.